The following opinions are solely those of BoatTest.com and its test captain.
Hi, Captain Steve for BoatTest.com, and today we're going to be taking a look at the Scout 350 LXF.
First, let's look at the test results. The 350 LXF has a length overall of 34 feet 11 inches, a beam of 10 feet 9 inches, and a draft of 23 inches. With a dry weight of 9,100 pounds, full fuel, and three people on board, we had a test weight of 12,461 pounds. With triple 300 Evinrude E-Tech G2 engines turning 15 by 20 stainless steel props, we reached a top speed of 5850 RPM of 59.4 miles per hour. At that speed, we were burning 72.7 gallons per hour, giving us a range of 265 miles. Best cruise came in at 3500 RPM and 33.8 miles per hour. That speed reduced the fuel burn to 22.7 gallons per hour and increased the range to 483 miles. We had a time to plane of 3.4 seconds and reached 30 miles per hour in 7.1 seconds. Her heavy weight certainly gives her a solid feel, but more importantly, with many turns of the wheel from lock to lock, things don't happen quickly on the 350 LXF, nor should they. Her characteristics could put her more in the realm of being a gentle giant. Once on plane, she settles into her normal 5-degree bow high attitude. She does like to lean into the turns, which keeps everyone planted throughout rather than being tossed to one side. While we would love to validate her seakeeping ability, we had flat calm conditions on test day. However, she did show docile handling characteristics when crossing wakes. Now, let's look at her features. As for some of her general features, she's an impressive boat. A large sun pad starts out the bow features, wraparound bolsters add to the comfort level, and recessed powder-coated grab rails add to the safety factor. A button to the starboard side bulwarks actuates the pneumatic pedestal, causing the table to rise and create a comfortable dining area. I should mention here, the quality of the materials used by Scout are first rate. The seats are comfortable throughout, and the color scheme ties the boat together well. Just ahead, a hatch covers the concealed through-the-stem anchor and windlass, and control switches are just behind to deploy and retrieve the ground tackle. Moving aft, there's a double-wide lounge just ahead of the console, and this will surely be among the most popular places to relax when underway. Flip-down armrests to both sides add to the comfort level. Of course, we can enjoy the view next to the captain as the observer gets the same comfortable seat with a flip-up bolster and flip-down armrests. A storage armrest is in between. When it's time to get wet, a cockpit door leads to the aft platform and the swimmery boarding ladder. The teak platform allows walking room to both sides and across the front of the engines. Inside the console, there's a head, small galley, and berth for overnighting. This aft-facing bench seat allows for comfort while watching the lines and enhances the fishing features. Underneath is a live well with sliding cover and storage to both sides for keeping tackle organized. A cleverly designed transom bench seat deploys and stows easily, so we can be comfortable while cruising out to the fishing grounds and then open up the cockpit space when it's time to go to work. The center deck hatch allows access to all the bilge, live well, and raw water pumps. Huge in-deck fish lockers are to both sides. A 60-gallon transom fish box lies across the stern. To the port, there's a large outward opening hull side door that we can haul tuna through and also allows us to utilize the 350 LXF as a dive platform. Rocket launchers are located both high and low across the back of the hardtop, plus we've got accommodations for outriggers. And notice how the hardtop supports with the integral grab handles seamlessly blend into the console. This not only saves from having supports narrowing in the side decks, it also looks great. There's certainly no shortage of storage space on board the 350 LXF. There's lengthy undergunnel storage to both sides of the lounge ahead of the console. Aft-facing speakers are to the forward sides, and a stereo control is just to the port side. Of course, there's ample storage under the lounge accessed by the lift and lock latch to the front. Inside, there's plenty of space for gear. In our opinion, the 350 LXF represents a good crossover boat between hard offshore work and easy days of relaxation. We're impressed with the quality of materials and the fit and finish expected of this brand.
And that's our look at the Scout 350 LXF. For BoatTest.com, I'm Captain Steve. We'll see you on the water.